In this video, I'm going to go over how to convert between moles and atoms or molecules. And so for this whole video, I'm going to be using the analogy of a dozen. And chances are, if you're starting to learn about moles in your class, this is not the first time you've heard the analogy that a mole is like a dozen. It really is the exact same concept. A dozen just exists because it's easier to say a couple dozen than to say 24 things. And it's the same thing with moles. It's just easier to say a few moles than to actually say the number of atoms or molecules you'd have, which would most likely be a really high number. So in your class, you're probably going to do problems like this on the left-hand side. But before we do that, let's go ahead and do a problem that's easier to immediately understand over here, which is going to be just doing the exact same type of problems, but instead of mole conversions, we're going to be doing conversions between dozens and number of bagels. If we have to calculate the number of bagels in 4.3 dozens, this just immediately makes more sense to us than doing any type of mole problems. Because if we look up here and we have, let's say, one dozen, we just automatically know that equals 12 bagels. And so if we say, okay, we have two dozens, we just automatically know that's going to equal 24 bagels. We don't have to think about this too hard. We just really understand what a dozen is already. So it's easy for us to just go ahead and answer these questions. And so now if we think about our conversion going back and forth between dozens and numbers of bagels, we can see when we go this direction from dozens to bagels, what we're really doing is multiplying by 12. And when we go in the reverse direction, if I said I had 24 bagels, how many dozens do I have? What we're really doing is dividing by 12. In this example, it just was instinctual. It's like, well, of course, yeah, that's just makes sense when you're talking about bagels and dozens. But because a dozen is the same exact concept as a mole, we can do the same thing for our conversion on the left-hand side. So when we're converting from moles to number of particles, we have to multiply by Avogadro's number. And when we have to go from number of particles to moles, we have to divide by Avogadro's number. All right, so now that we kind of understand the math steps involved, let's go ahead and actually answer our bagel question. So in this case, we start with the number of dozens, 4.3 dozens. So I think it can be really useful on these types of problems to label your start and your finish. So your start is whatever you're given in the problem. In this case, we're starting with dozens. And your finish is whatever the problem is asking you to find. In this case, we're asked to calculate the number of bagels. And now that we know this, we know what math we're going to have to do. To get from start to finish, we're going to have to follow our arrow that takes us there, which is to multiply by 12. So our math is going to look like this. First, we have 4.3 dozens. We can set up like this. And now we're going to have to multiply by 12, but I'm not going to just use the number. I'm going to do it really properly and show you the units. And so the units of a dozen are 12 things per dozen. And in this case, our thing is bagels. So it looks like this. So dozens goes in the denominator because per is our math word for divide. So when I say 12 bagels per dozen, it means that bagels is going to go in the numerator just like 12. Per says anything after that's going to be on the bottom, and then it's dozens on the bottom. And so we can see this is actually helpful because this allows us to cancel out. So we have this, and now we can see that our math is what we needed it to be. It's multiplying 4.3 times 12, and so we end up with 51.6. We only have two sig figs coming from 4 and 3, so we can only keep these two spots. We have to round up, and our final answer is 52 bagels. All right, so this is exactly how we're going to do our problem that actually involves molecules and moles. So, starting off with our start and our finish, we are given 1.058 moles. This is our start. We are asked to find the number of molecules, so that's our finish. And I put number of particles in this box because sometimes you're going to be doing molecules, sometimes you're going to be doing atoms, but it's usually going to be some type of particle. And so now that we have our start and our finish, we can draw our arrow and we can see we're going to have to follow this arrow. We're going to have to multiply by Avogadro's number. So we set it up like this. 1.058 mole, put that all over 1, and now when we multiply by Avogadro's number, again, just like how dozen had units, we're going to have to use units with Avogadro's number. And so it looks like this. 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd molecules per mole. Whatever you're going to be calculating, that's going to be your particle, so you just sub that in. And then again, just like how dozens had a per, Avogadro's number is always whatever you're doing per mole. And this allows us to cancel out our 2 moles, which is good because we want to end up in molecules. And now all we have to do is to multiply our 1.058 times 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd. And so I have this little box here saying calculator hint. I have this here because I've noticed that a lot of the problems that students have with moles have to do with how they're putting all the calculations into their calculator. And so if you're going to enter it as 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd, you can, but you have to use parentheses always. Otherwise, your calculator is going to misread the PEMDAS steps and it's going to give you probably the right first part of the answer, but the exponents are going to probably be wrong. So what I recommend is entering it as 6.02E23. And so however you're going to find that capital E, it's going to be slightly different on whatever calculator you have. It could be one capital E, could be two, could be EXP. Sometimes it's 10 to the X, but I definitely recommend finding out whatever that is and then learning how to use it, because that's going to be way faster than always entering in parentheses. I can't emphasize this enough. If you're entering it in 6.02 times 10 to the 23 and you're not using parentheses, you're not going to get the answers right. It's going to mess up all of your calculations. So make sure you always use them or figure out how to use your capital E. All right, so now we can go ahead, insert it into the calculator, and we get 6.37 times 10 to the 23rd molecules. All right, and so just one last sig fig note here. I used 3 sig figs because I included Avogadro's number as having sig figs because it is a measurement that can be more accurate than this. But some teachers are going to not have you use that. And if your teacher says, don't ever account for sig figs for Avogadro's number, you would go ahead and use 4 sig figs because you have 4 sig figs right here. That's just going to be a class per class difference. All right, let's do a couple more problems. All right, so again, the ones we care about for class are over here on the left-hand side. But before we do that, let's go ahead and do this one just so we can kind of get a conceptual understanding before we get into atoms and moles. So if we're asked to calculate the number of dozens in 8,204 bagels, labeling our start and our finish, we are given the number of bagels, that's our start. We are asked to find the number of dozens, that's our finish. So to get from start to finish, we're going to have to follow this arrow and divide by 12. So that will look like this. 8,204 bagels divided by 12 bagels per dozen. And so we can either write it like this where we divide, or instead of dividing by 12, we can multiply by the reciprocal of the definition of a dozen. So if we do that, it'll look like this. So filling in the reciprocal, everything in 12 bagels per dozen is going to have to flip sides. So within 12 bagels per dozen, 12 and bagels were on the numerator, so that means it's going to be on the denominator here. And dozen was on the denominator, which means it's going to be on the numerator here. So now we can kind of see more clearly what we're going to have to do. We're going to have to cancel out bagels, that's good. And now we have to divide 8,204 by 12. And so just kind of doing a double check in our brains, we can say, okay, if we had 8,000 bagels, it makes sense that the number of dozens was less than that, right? If we had 8,000 bagels, we wouldn't expect to have 20,000 dozens of bagels. That wouldn't make any sense. So the fact that we got 683.7, it's like, all right, that makes sense. So I encourage you to always do these kind of mental double checks, kind of checking, does that make sense in your head with any mole problem. So going over to our actual mole problem, calculate the number of moles in 4.517 times 10 to the 23rd atoms of iron. And so again, labeling our start and our finish. So we are given the number of atoms, that's particles. We're asked for the number of moles, that's our finish. So to get from start to finish, we're going to have to follow this bottom arrow and divide by Avogadro's number. So that's going to look like this. And so I can either look at it like this, or if I want to see all the units kind of clearly cancel out, I can multiply by the reciprocal. So now looking down here and flipping everything, I'm going to have 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd on the bottom. That's going to be with atoms. And I'm going to have moles on top. And so one note, I'm going to change the units of Avogadro's number for every problem I have, depending on what I need to cancel out. In our previous problem, it was molecules, so I had molecules per mole. In this problem, it's atoms, so I have atoms per mole. And so if you want to, you can always just do particles per mole and then cancel out whatever your particles are. So now canceling out atoms, we're going to end up in mole, which is what we wanted, and our final number is this. 0.750 mole. Again, I'm using 3 sig figs because I'm choosing to use Avogadro's number as sig figs because it is technically a measurement, but your teacher might just have you only do the numbers that were given to you in the problem. So now let's do a double check. If we look at our number of atoms that we had, 4.517 times 10 to the 23rd, we can see that number is less than the definition of Avogadro's number. It's less than 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd. So now the fact that we have a number that's less than 1 mole, that makes sense. If our number had been higher, it would make sense that we'd have over 1 mole. So always do these double checks whenever you can. If you're ever getting confused about moles, try to remember it just is the same concept as a dozen, just with a harder math number than 12. All right, hope this video was useful, and as always, happy studying.
Hey, I hope you liked that video. Please feel free to subscribe, click around and watch my other tutorials, and as always, happy studying.